Hey, it's Jamie, the urban wine buff, and welcome to Alphabetically Wine, y'all. Today's letter is the letter U, and U is for understanding wine styles. Okay, so as we all know, wine can be a bit complicated. You have all these different wine grapes, regions, flavors, aromas, textures, tannins, all that good stuff. However, in this video, I just want to break down the five basic styles of wine, which include red, white, rosé, sparkling, and dessert. Let's get started. Okay, so for red wines, I have a red wine here. This is a Pinot Noir, but some other examples of red wine include Merlot, Malbec, Cabernet Sauvignon, Zinfandel. Yeah, Zinfandel is actually a red grape, y'all. Sangiovese, there are just so many. So you have red wines, right? So red wines are made from grapes that are red or black, right? So one thing I want you to know about red wine grapes, though, is that the inside is almost always white. That's true of all wine grapes. Like, the inside is going to be white, so the actual juice itself is white. But in the case of red wines, they go through a process called maceration. So what happens is the winemaker crushes the grapes and just allows the juice to just sit and marinate along with the grape skins, and that's where the color of the wine comes from. Okay, so the longer the maceration process, the darker and the bolder the wine is going to be. Okay, another thing that you want to know about red wines is that they are mostly dry. I know everybody always asks for a sweet red wine. In the case of these just artisan wines, most red wines are dry. You can find a sweet one here and there, but most of them are going to be dry. But they can also vary in body. So they can be light bodied, like this Pinot Noir. They can be medium bodied, or they can just be big and full bodied, like a Cabernet Sauvignon. If you need to catch up on what body means, go ahead and check out my B video, B is for body. I break it down for you there, okay? So let's move on to white wines, okay? Let's go. Okay, so for white wines, okay, some examples of white wines would be Chardonnay, Pinot Grigio, Riesling, Moscato, all that good stuff. So for the case of white wines, they are typically made from white or green wine grapes most of the time. However, they can also be made from red grapes as well, because like I said, the actual color of the wine comes from the grape skins, not the actual insides. So there are some cases occasionally where the winemaker has like a Pinot Noir. Like, I had a white Pinot Noir one time. Like, they took the Pinot Noir and just crushed the grape and got all the juice out of it before it can sit and get the color from the grape skin. So you ended up with a white wine that was made from a red grape. But in general, white wines are made from white or green wine grapes. In the same case as the red wines, they can be full bodied like a California Chardonnay, or they can be really light bodied like a Riesling or a Sauvignon Blanc. It all depends. Go back and look at body again. They can vary in sweetness as well. One tip that I want to give you about looking at wine bottles and to kind of gauge if a wine is sweet or not is to look at the alcohol volume. So when you look at the back of a wine bottle, it's going to show you how much alcohol is in the wine. Anything like under 10% alcohol is a sweet wine, okay? So it's like, for sweet wines, it's like they have all the sugar, but the fermentation will stop before the sugar can all be converted into alcohol. So typically you're going to have sweeter tasting wines, but they're going to be lower in alcohol. So that's just a tip when you're looking for a sweet wine, look at the alcohol level. Most of the time, if it's under 10%, it's going to be sweet. Okay, let's go. Okay, so rosé wines. You know what those are. Those are the pretty pink and the salmon colored wines, and they're really just really fun to look at and fun to drink. Okay, really pretty. Now for rosé wines, they can be made basically from any type of grape, but mostly they're red because of the color, right? So just like I explained before, like you can have a wine made from Pinot Noir, you can have a rosé made from Sangiovese, any type of a wine grape actually, but the maceration process is shorter. So they just leave the grape skins to marinate with the juice just for a little bit, just to give it a tinge of color. So that's where the color comes from, and that's how you get rosé wines. And in the case of rosé, they can be sweet or dry as well, but most rosés are dry too. They can have all kind of flavors. They can be dry, sweet, they can be fruity, they can be savory. It just depends on the type of grape that was used to make it and where the rosé wine comes from. So y'all know what sparkling is, right? That's the bubbly, right? That's the champagne. But let me tell y'all something about that. Okay, champagne has to come from Champagne, France in order to be considered actual champagne. So if you don't learn anything else about sparkling wine today, just know that champagne is from Champagne, okay? Otherwise, you're not referring to it correctly, okay? So champagne has to be from Champagne, but you have sparkling wines from everywhere. You have sparkling wines from Italy, so that'll be your Prosecco. You got sparkling wines from Spain, that'll be your Cava. You got USA sparkling wine, and it might just say just sparkling wine on the bottle. You might see something that says like California Champagne. That's just a legal loophole, like, because Champagne actually has like a legal hold on the name and on the uses of champagne. But like back in the day, before they got that, California was able to call it champagne and get away with it due to a legal loophole. But it's not the same, okay? Like, don't get me no California champagne unless you're gonna make like some mimosas with it, because if you get it from me and say, oh, this is champagne, I'm gonna be like, and no, it's not. I want the kind from Champagne, France. But you don't have to be like me. Sparkling wine is good no matter where it comes from. It's just like champagne is like, it's like the Gucci or something of sparkling wines. Like, you can't just call everything Gucci because they are similar in appearance. You know what I mean? So the same with that. Okay, I've rambled too long. Let's go on into dessert wines, okay? Okay, so dessert wines are your sweet wines. There are different types of dessert wines as well. I'm gonna go through them real fast. The more famous one would be like your port wines. The port wines is a fortified wine. Brandy has been added to it to spike the alcohol content. So that just happens to be a sweet wine with an elevated alcohol content because brandy was added to it, okay? Then you have your Moscato, of course. You have ice wine. If you don't know what ice wine is, check out my video, Eyes for Ice Wine. I break it down there. You have late harvest wine. So if you have a wine bottle and it says late harvest on it, it doesn't matter what type of grape it is, it's gonna be sweet, okay? And then you have botrytis or noble rot wines. That is a fungus that actually grows on the grapes that, it like punctures holes in the grape skins and all the water evaporates, and it just leaves you with like a concentrated sugar in the grapes. So you have an extremely sweet wine. So an example of that would be Sauternes, which I think I talked about before, but I'll find it for you guys. So anyway, so go ahead and let me know what you think about those. Which is your favorite? What are you sipping on right now? Go ahead and leave the comments below. Go ahead and like, share, follow, subscribe, all of that, y'all. And meet me at the next video. Let's go.